I just realized I didn't have my recorder on. I'm using this new GoPro, and sometimes if you don't press the button hard enough, or you just touch it, it doesn't work. So that's probably what happened. I just didn't touch the button hard enough. So what I was saying before, you know, before I wasn't recording, when I wasn't recording, was I'm putting this down first because I want to cut down on all the granulation of the foam that's on the cut area. The sides I'm not worried about as much, but this top area definitely was, because you don't want to get it in your clay and have to battle with granules all day, all week, or all the whole time that you're sculpting it. It's best to take care of it. All right, I'm going to start building up the sides. You always got to start with a foundation, and in this case, the foundation is the base. What I do is I take the clay and I just put it right to the edge of the circle. That's why I didn't worry about the clay or the foam going to the edge, because this is more accurate in the long run. And then you just fill in behind it. I'm using this pasta cutter, or whatever this thing is called, I guess a pastry cutter, to straighten out the walls and make them 90 degrees to the board by just putting it flat on the table and scraping the clay. That gets it back to the line and make sure that it's even 90 degrees all the way around. See, he's lifting this foot up, so that's what I'm going to indicate right here. That's why I raised that up a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna have to warm some clay up for the rest of this piece because it's just, I'm down to the last few pounds in this batch that I cut up a long time ago.